shit, man. There's 18K up top. 7K to first. Oops. I could just jam this in. It would be profitable. We will realize this in position, though. Especially first hand, the heads up. Kind of a gross swap. We don't have that much A6. We do have some, though. We don't call like this. I'm going to play a very different heads up game than you guys are used to, probably, seeing. I play jackpots, spinning goes, whatever you want to call them, all day. Lots of limping, lots of defending position, lots of taking some strength. It would be reasonable to continue here. He has been pretty tight. We'll just give him this one. We had just like one backdoor suit. I'd definitely be continuing that. Even then, it's arguable to continue. Okay, so let's get this. Wait, is this three-handed?
Oh,
three-handed. Yeah. So it's a little off. It has more hands than I should on this guy. It's like 33 samples. It might be, might have played in the spinning goes. I'm not sure. Thank you for following me, the merciless. You're already falling. Thank you for the refall, sir. And Morris 2893, quick click, Leo Augusto. All right, I must have got you guys already. So this is the HUD I normally use when I get heads up in a spin and go. We got 7K swing. We're definitely bringing out a HUD. Hey, congratulations to the people who bought into my package. We're now going to break even, at least, on the series. At least going to break even. Very, very close to a full. I might check raise this combo. I actually don't even expect him to bet that much clubs here. It's up such a different beast. I wouldn't be surprised to get jammed on here, but I also wouldn't be surprised just to see a fold. Interesting. Alright, we'll continue on street. Actually, at this point, I wouldn't be surprised to get clubs playing it this way. I expected a lot of bet folds there. But I'm still barreling this. Fuck me. Alright, we're going for it. Snap at the club. Alright. That makes sense. It's fine, guys. We still got it. I mean, the way I rep the hand, right? I mean, unless you have Queen Jack, like, you know, like some Jack X with club hands would make a lot of sense too. I mean, I don't hate my triple barrel bluff there. It just ran out like too perfect for my range not to. There were some turns I wouldn't do that with. Oh, it's my turn to flop a flush. Who knows, maybe he'll pay us off again. Huh, buddy? Huh, buddy? Alright, well, that time we folded. Interesting. Do you think I was just, like, be honest from now on those sports? I'm actually going to check this combo 10x. I need to keep some strength in my check back. Range is particularly good, 10-2 check back, because it has less problem turns, 7-3, 2-8. I'll bring it straight draws with block, a block, being a blocker as well. Thank you for the follow, HSchmidt85. We'll be winning this turn, though. Should call at least one. Probably just check it out this turn. Oh, definitely not betting this flop. Very bad for my range. We will delay C-bet some turns. Probably like any 9-10 jack. Check back king and ace. Check back everything else. Maybe an 8 because I do realize some value. So we will bluff that turn. Although he might just lead. It was exactly the turn I said I was going to bluff, so we bluff it. Should be very rarely folding the button on this deep. Hurricane is a super knit, don't spew. Okay, it's a super knit. So weird they super nicks. I had him in like a 42-32 before I came into this final table. Oh, he's no super nit like you guys said. I'm just giving up this. I'm about a 5. Pretty sure we're only drawn to a 5 here, unless he like floated like queen high. Interesting, he doesn't leave the river. But we just had queen high ace right here. Nope. You expecting me to like bluff that river? Defending against a... Interesting. Really strong for my range. Burn his hand. For the fall pushing price. This actually isn't a flop. I'd normally see it after min raising. But you guys said he's a super net, so that's true. It's fine.
Oh, yeah.
And Blue Star Theory, Brian Moore. Thank you guys. I won't be check raising this combo of King Queen X. I know I hit trip, right? But like the combos I want to check all here, Queen Jack and Queen 9, with less problems when like it run out. It's really hard for it to run out where I'm like, wow, that's a 4-card straight. That really, really sucks when I have a 9, like, cause, you know, even if Broadway runs out, we have a straight, and we block the other end too. It would, like, you know, full house us. The debatable thing is leading the turn. I mean, I'm assuming he's just gonna check give up, tons of turns here, even if I check raise this board. I mean, this is like our best case scenario for us, that the board ran out this way. Due to the fact there's a lot of missed draws now, and I could have like some random flat, I mean, it's unlikely, right? I mean, that's the most likely scenario. Just goes bet fold. You definitely don't need to stab every pair of boards, especially when it's good for his range. Interesting. I'll get a better idea as we go through this heads-up match, what he's doing. I definitely want to look for some not only 3-bet hands. This is not it. This is just a flat. Keep him strength in our flat back range. Some aces. We'll float at least once. Not the best flop. Interesting, being such a wet board though. Questionable continue. Play some cash after you take this down. Is he really been king high on this board? So tempted to call, but I'd rather call here probably with like queen 8 than I would ace 3. With the blockers. So for that reason, I'm going to have better hands to call here. Very interesting. He's going to a nuts or nothing polarization here. So he's saying he has ace 7, queen 10, or like king 5, king 6. I don't know how much I believe it, but we don't really have any hand to combat that. I like being super aggro heads up. That's what most people like. It's not actually what I like. And we were aggro the hand into a bluff. Where's the quill your board at? We will consider changing gears to that at one point, Leo. As we start min-racing some stuff and seeing where he's at. Well, I probably do call this river unless he goes like a huge sizing. I'm pretty confident in my ability to win this hand. I still think he leads some jack x here. Does he lead all of it? No. Like, he's not leading jack 2 through jack 6, but I think he's leading in jack 9 plus. I don't think I want to go for thin value on this board, though. Okay, interesting turn lead. I will not 3-bet this hand. This is the kind of hand I was looking for. Like, you know, I do want some aces. I do want some kings, queens. Or maybe not aces, but like kings, queens, jacks, tens. For an 3-bets, and then I want some balance, some board coverage with hands like this. I don't really want to ever be 3-bet fold off 6-5 suited, so you need some of this offsuit equity. Definitely leading this board. I would lead this board with my entire range, given this is particularly good for me. If he raises here, it would be really sick. It would be really sick if we just jam. That would be the sickest. I don't think he has a jam range here, though. Nice. Let's go. Music got me watching your skills, got me following. Thank you. I know I talked about delayed c-betting. So I'm still going to delay c-bet this. It's kind of gross, though, because it was like my... I expect to lead all queens and sevens here. I will call the turn. I do check with a lot of queens. I will just bet small here. This isn't like an indication of my hand strength. It's an indication of the board texture. I don't like changing my hands, my sizing based off of... hand strength. I like changing my strength sizing based off board texture and stack depth. Thank you for the follow, Ashiaku. This is a little different position. I actually don't want to be raised folding off 6-7 off. This is where all the limp strategy came from heads up. It's like people want, realize they want to realize equity with this, and getting 3-bet jammed off of these hands constantly was really bad. And then to balance that, like, all kinds of limps got created, and there was like, oh, we'll just limp everything. Like, fucking sounds great. Curious at what Ming the Merciless thinks about that hand. We will bet this flop. This is not a flop. Like, we would not have much equity that we're delay c-betting here. We're just betting one and giving up, though. There's not really any turns in the world. Maybe... You know, I still want a double barrel king. I like to have some kind of equity in my double barrels. Alright, you're gonna win this one. You're saying I'm too nitty heads up or someone else? Interesting, like I could actually barrel this river, I'm not going to. Oh wow. That's actually like a terrible sizing to be nuts or nothing, because it's like most of the gut shots merged into something there. Like if it was a bluff, it's like, okay, grats. You didn't need to go that big on such a polarizing board. But at the same point, it might be a board, he's like, well, he's ever calling, he's not. And you might be right. I'm gonna check back this king. Usually I'd only be checking back my king 2, king 3, king 4 here. I do have a particularly okay king. It's not like a great king to see betting. I do have the king spades. I would bet see bet my king 5, king 4 without a spade though to make up for it. I'm actually gonna double check this. This is how I'm gonna achieve keeping strength in my double check range. We will be calling those rivers.
Oh.
I doubt we ever get value here. Well, we're still betting small. Maybe levels of the, maybe he just doesn't see my hand, that's fine. Thank you, Call Balls, for the follow. Some of these start becoming close as a 3-bet jam as he starts raising too much in position. This would be a reasonable one, I'm not going to take it. I think I have a big enough edge here in this heads up. Not to be taking it. This is probably going to be a check call, three streets type hand. We'll see how it runs out. There are board textures that will actually get him off this hand. Hard to fold heads up. Very interesting. Flop check. Very interesting. I do think he has a lot of 9x in the flop check. And I do think he will lead some of his 9x on this turn. So I don't necessarily think I can fold it, but not the best turn, of course. Watch out, talking strat guy probably watching. Yeah, I hear you, DJ Plays Poker. Thank you, buddy. He probably is.
Oh, yeah.
Just is what it is. Part of the fun of being streaming is... Thank you for the follow, Robert D221. You're giving out all this free information. Oh, interesting turn bet with Queen 10. I mean, I am putting pressure in my own way in my analysis. Putting post-flop pressure. It just might not seem it. We're just going to pick this guy apart, man. At least we're going to try. Doesn't always work how you want. Can't always get what you want. We will bet this turn. We will call this one barrel. Alright. $18K would be a very, very nice score. I should change the title. Head up for the win. I mean, it's also a kind of thing where the longer this match goes, the more powerful my HUD gets too. I know, right? All these HUD haters are probably going to come in with... It is what it is. Having a really good HUD and heads up is very, very important. Interesting turn. I do have the blocker. I will be the check call this turn. I don't need to lead this turn. I would lead a lot of 10Xs though. But not this 10X. Interesting as fuck, river. He has a check full. Vomit the river, man. Vomit river! Vomit river. What is with your sizing? I mean, that's, I'm starting to lean towards some of this is bluff sizings, but it's like, he had ample opportunity to take his non-equity hands into a bluff, so it's very interesting. Alright, since we've been raising some of our 6-4, 6-5 offs, let's take 10-7 off for some board coverage. We would have some ace kings, ace queens, ace jacks here. Reasonable flop to see bit. Song request from D Tusk. I think I'm actually gonna double barrel this for both for value and blocking reasons. But value block, like, I do not let him realize some gut shots. And if I do, and if he does just check call on ace, I do get a chance conversion to a 10 or 7 for all of it. And I could potentially get value out of an 8. I mean, I could just get check ripped on here, unlikely, but it's possible. Alright, D-Tusk, what do you want for a song request? Nice. That works. Is CR a cheap place to live? No. Very expensive, actually. Alright, you win this board. You win. You win. Cough at the pot. Cough at the pot, buddy. Godsmack voices, you gotta turn it in, Leo. You gotta turn it in under info to get a to get a song request. Especially when I'm playing heads up. I'm not gonna go under my way if people aren't turning it in to get a song request in, buddy. Thank you for the follow. Mr. 305 Aug. And maybe Robert D, maybe a second shout out. Ooh, that flop. God, so face up on my check back as well. Alright, there's enough gut shots out there. Draws other stuff. Who knows, maybe he leverages himself some percent of the time. Meh, meh. I shouldn't like playing that face up heads up, but it would be a reasonable check back. I could just jam here. I do okay, but I do okay checking this back too. D-Tusk has this song. Alright, here is D-Tusk's song. We're just gonna check all this down. We could check raise it too, but if he's an idiot, I think he is. He might just be apt to believe me. And we got a song request from Mountie Truth, so you'll be up next, buddy. I mean, the good thing about this river, right? Or not turn, it doesn't merge my gut shots, and it makes me a little, like, it isn't over to a 3. More likely 2 double barrel. I mean, this is one of these spots he's just gonna have to show me a better hand on the river. There's not really a river that I fold. There is not a river I fold. I mean, if he has a 6 here, that's absurd. But here, I check call any. Do what you want to do, Hurricane. Do what you want to do, buddy. He might even just bluff and, like, think maybe at 5-4, 5-2 here. Alright, let's go. Let's go. You didn't reach me on that, did you, buddy? Like I said, guys, we bluffed on our stack. Ain't no worry. Let's fucking go. Let's go. I mean, I do have equity. It's just such a clean board to have a limp C-bet on. That 5-minute delay commentary, dope. 190 seconds, sir. Are you lit, though? No, I'm not. Good double barrel. Queen high is not enough equity here to realize. Again, I'm actually going to go a little bit smaller sizing here. Just because the stacks are getting a little thinner. Just a little bit, right? I was banking 60%, now 50. Right, equity to do that with. It's just like a naked queen, right? So it's not like I get that much value necessarily when we get in the river. Alright, this is gonna be Jam City. Let's go. Jay Arito, thank you for the follow. I like this song. What was it? Nobody Speak featuring Run the Jewels, DJ Shadow. Thank you for that, DJ Shadow. We will let him get an ace 8 off. I mean, he should be coming with some jams over our lamps. So it looks like the world. Especially if he's watching this heads up. A really bad flop for us. Really, really all over what I perceive him checking back here. Then again, I do expect him to start jamming like his king 2s, king 3s over some of these limps. So maybe not as strong for his range as normal, but he might not realize that he should be jamming that part of his range. Interesting. Just gonna give it to him, even with the gut shot and over to the 5. 2 over to the 5. We got him on the ropes. No real reason to fight with him right now. This final table or a heads-up tourney. Final table for 18 doll hairs. 18K up top. Checking his back. Worst combo of 3 here. And we realize some really good turns with his hand. We do block that. If he does lead, we'll call at least one with this particular combo. All right, I'll have a double check here. I might call some rivers. I think he leads his 4-6 here on the turn. Very interesting if he leads this river. I might find a call. Alright, we'll just check and shut down. Hopefully I have the best hand. Okay, that works. That is fine, that is fine. What was our next song request? Monty Ruth, what was your song request? A minute window me, please. Alright, this is actually fine as a jam. Very standard jam, actually. Especially if I think he has some. God damn it. All of it, boys. All of it. We're never that far behind with Jack 5 suited. All of it. I'm sorry, man. We're going to do your song request another time. $18,000 on stream. $18,318. Everyone who invested in my fucking package. We got fucking 3 days to go. We've already won money. Let's go. Let's go. Thank you guys all so fucking much for the follow and following through on this. I was like, wasn't even watching the round, man. I was going looking for a fucking song, right? That's how fucking relaxed we were. We had this shit. Yeah, it's fine, because he's already limp-folded a couple times. It's okay. It is fine. But let's not spoiler, guys. Let's not spoiler. Oh, I guess he was talking about another Jack 5. All right, let's find a host. Let's find a host. Who are we hosting? There is no one on. There is no one on. I don't know anybody on, really. I'll ask you guys, who should I host? Hurricane is clueless. I mean, he didn't seem clueless. Like, he's a reg. Like, he's winning money. We knew more about heads up than he did, for sure. But that's a different story all in itself. Wearing Duray, I'm wearing a hat, man. It says the D. That's what we gave him, the D. We gave him the D. G, wearing the Duray. It looks like a Duray. How has this guy not shoved once? Jimmy Jam, let's fucking go. Yeah, let's fucking go. We bluffed off. We doubled him up. We gave him the chip lead early on, bluffing him off 3 streets. Don't matter. We got it. We got it. We got it. All right, let's watch that beautiful thing. Let's watch it again on stream. Let's watch it again on stream. Get him, get him. Good luck all. I need a host. I need a host. I should get on Skype and ask. We're still looking for a host. Psychological war. Psychological war. Where the fuck? Where is everybody tonight? Alright. I guess we're hosting Zaxxor. I guess what we're doing. Seems like a nice guy. And his name's Zach. My name's Zach. And he spells Zach the same as me. So that's who we're hosting.
Yeah.
Thank you, guys. Thank you, Nice Fool Football.